my brother was 16, and we still haven't seen justice yet. They want to buy us off. They want to pay us up to shut us up. We can't stand for this anymore. I won't accept money for what they did to my brother. I won't accept it until they get held accountable, for their murder. Until we see justice, they don't see peace.
That's right.
No more. No more will we stand in the streets. No more will we stand in the streets peaceful on the sidewalk waiting for them.
Hell yeah.
Waiting for them to tell us that we're going to jail for doing our right. For our right to fight against the system when they come against us. They waged war against us. They waged war against my family and your families also. They're waging war against us. When will we stop and start waging war against them?
That's right.
It might sound scary, but what they're doing is scarier to us. They're killing us in cold blood. They're lying in cold in front of our faces. The news is not here for us. The news is not here to report the shit that they really are doing. They hunted my brother down just like they will hunt your brothers and sisters down. They kept him in an institution that took his life away, that caused him to come home messed up. And they said that he was paranoid. No, they killed him. They made him paranoid. They forced us to do what they want so that they can get paid. Shut Down Rikers is here with the stop mass incarceration. This is another jail cell. We're living in a jail cell.
Fires and fires and fires and bullet after bullet after bullet ripping to his chest, ripping to his back, taking his life away. Think about that video. And I ask you, speak honestly and from the heart. Are you ready to take the streets today?
Yeah!
Are you ready to march
yeah!
today?
Yeah!
Are you ready to put it on the line to say no more?
Yeah!
No more!
No more!
No more!
No more!
All right, people power. All power to the people.
All power to the people.
Do not let no one silence you. I see the crowd is growing. We look to be about 2,000 strong out here right now. 2,000 freedom-loving people. We need some more. So keep tweeting, keep Facebooking, keep texting all your friends and loved ones, and tell them to join you here right now in Union Square. Join you right here, right now, in Union Square. We need to get to 10,000 or 50,000, and we're gonna take these streets and let them know that these are our streets. We are gonna show them that we will not be silent. We're gonna let them know that we have the will to resist, that we will persist and resist all of this corruption, all of this brutality. I thank you all. Keep tweeting, keep texting, keep Facebooking, keep sharing the pictures, and bring the people out.
Nice hat.
We can't fight each other.
Hey, you guys,
We got a loved one here. You guys know you're listening to the mother of Eric Garner's daughter. And there was some disrespect, but we want a lot of love from the crowd. Because this sister is struggling to share what's in her heart. Okay? Even if she said it already, and even if you heard it already, I want everybody to tune in, and she's going to share with us from her heart, okay?
We with you. Okay, thank you.
Quiet. Why are we fighting each other? We're not here to fight each other.
All right, just let it
go. Eric Garner. Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Eric Garner.
Okay, here we go. Just a few words. Okay, she's going to stay up here with us, but she's done for the moment.
Joshua Lopez, my uncle was murdered in 2011 by an undercover police officer who was just breaking up a fight, and he didn't know this undercover police officer was a police officer. And I'm holding these two articles right now in my hand because this is the face of America. Police officers in America have murdered more people than the September 11 attack, than the Orlando massacre, and the Oklahoma City bombing all combined together. Police have murdered more people combined. And I'm here to tell you that this year alone, police have murdered over 500 people. And I'm telling you, enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
They asked us to keep calm, but we've been calm over 400 years. They told us to keep calm when they murdered Emmett Till in 1955. And what did communists do for our family members who was murdered?
Nothing.
So it's time to fight back by any means necessary.
That's right.
Revolution and nothing less.
Revolution. Nothing less.
Thank you. Thank you.
Woo!
Justice for
John Delisle.
Say his name.
John Delisle.
What's his name?
John Delisle.
We okay. Gonna be all right.
What?
We 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 gonna be all right.
Let's go.
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 We gonna be all right.
Affect me day to day. See, I'm here because I don't want my name to be a hashtag. See, I keep thinking about what I will say to the officer when I get pulled over. See, in my mind, it's not a matter of if, but it's a matter of when I'll get pulled over. See, I think about how I can't come across as a threat. See, how I have to allay people's fears of an image of me perpetuated by a media machine which knows nothing about me, my perspective, or the reflective of my inner struggles that I face day to day. See, I think about how I have to dress so I don't have to fit the description of the countless men, women, and children who have been reincarnated into hashtags on my Twitter feed. See, I think about my tone of voice, my mannerisms, the intensity of my eye contact so that people will not feel threatened around me. See, I think about the conversations I have to have with my little girl, how she must work twice as hard as her counterparts because of what she is in the eyes of our society. See, I think about having to think for other people. See, I think about how people always ask me to understand as if I can't read. See, I think about how people always call me sir when I'm wearing a suit with tie, but say hey you when I'm wearing a shirt and jeans. See, I think about how police officers always ask me am I parole before they even ask me what my name is. See, I think about how I gotta carry a pay stub in my pocket if I got more than $100 in cash, as if I'm not fully employed. See, I think about these things because I know that if I don't think about them, my life is in danger. So let me share.
Fuck these
racist police!
No justice!
No peace!
Fuck these killing
police!
What do we want?
Justice!
And when do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
If we don't get it,
shut it down!
We don't get it,
shut it down!
We don't get it,
shut it down!
But
think it's a game.
Ain't no game.
They think it's a joke.
Ain't no joke.
They think it's a game.
Ain't no game.
They think it's a joke.
Ain't no joke.
They think it's a game.
Ain't no game.
They think it's a joke.
Ain't no joke.
They think it's a game.
Ain't no game.
They think it's a joke.
Ain't no joke.
His name.
Austin Sterling.
Austin Sterling.
Scream his name. Austin Sterling.
Scream his name.
Austin Sterling.
Say his name.
Austin Sterling.
Who's this for?
I think that this is part of a large issue in America right now. There's so many things kind of flowing together at this point about class and race in America. It's important that we all stand together in solidarity.
Thank you very much.
Never leave a kid, 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 never leave a kid
sidewalk, must ensure that sufficient space is available for use by other pedestrians. If you unlawfully obstruct pedestrian traffic or walk in the street or roadway, you may be placed under arrest and charged with this.
Stop Planned Merida for its funding impunity. It's the same way. a simple ass question and you can't ask me like a man, you a coward. Ask straight up. Come on, be real with me. Be real with yourself. Be real with yourself. If you put your badge over your black skin after you're suffering in this fucking country for years, you a fucking coward. Those people are not a fucking coward, bro. I don't respect that shit. I gave you a chance, bro. I didn't prejudge you. I gave you a chance, but now I'm judging you. And I'm calling you a fucking coward. And I'm calling you a coward.
Where's the best place to hide after you commit a murder?
Behind your back. That's some coward shit, bro. That's some coward shit. It's corny as fuck.
The streets are blocks. We don't need these killer cops.